Please make them feel welcome. The United States Navy Blue Angels!
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Your United States Navy Flight Demonstration Squadron takes pleasure in performing for you this, our 53rd flight demonstration of the 2019 season. I'm Lieutenant Commander Cary Rickoff, narrator for the Blue Angels. Since 1946, the Blue Angels have had the unique privilege of demonstrating to the American public the precision techniques of naval aviation, hoping to inspire a culture of excellence and service to country. The maneuvers you will see demonstrated here this afternoon are coordinated tactical techniques developed by Navy and Marine Corps pilots in both peacetime training and actual combat. These maneuvers are neither stunts nor daring feats, but refinements of basic techniques taught to every prospective naval aviator. Here at Mather, we will demonstrate these maneuvers at very low altitude in traditional Blue Angel formation, so you may see and take pride in the precise fashion in which our Navy and Marine Corps pilots are trained to fly. Now direct your attention to the ramp before you. Observe the military manner in which the six demonstration pilots approach their aircraft and are saluted by their crew chiefs. Flying Blue Angel number 6, the opposing solo from Lawton, Oklahoma, Lieutenant Commander Andre Webb. Flying Blue Angel number 5, the lead solo from Wamego, Kansas, Lieutenant Commander Brandon Hempler.
See you, Daryl.
Flying Blue Angel number 4, the slot pilot from Memphis, Tennessee, Major Jeff Mullins. Flying Blue Angel number 3, the left wingman from Chesapeake, Virginia, Lieutenant Jim Cox. Flying Blue Angel number 2, the right wingman from Canadian, Texas, Lieutenant Commander James Haley. And Flying Blue Angel number 1, the commanding officer and flight leader of the Blue Angels from League City, Texas, Captain Eric Doyle. The pilots and crew chiefs will now start the General Electric engines that power the Boeing F-18. The noise level will soon become too high for you to hear a description of the checks they are performing. However, please note that each aircraft was carefully inspected by expert Blue Angel maintenance personnel prior to this afternoon's aerial demonstration. The Blue Angels fly the Boeing FA-18 Hornet, a multi-mission strike fighter, versions of which have been operational throughout the fleet since 1983.
7, big 120322, great 120320. You are clear to taxi via Delta, back taxi, 22 left, lot of weight, 22 left. Thanks, Beau, clear to taxi, lot of weight, 22 left.
Pilots 1 through 4.
All zeros. One are going to go down, right up.
Of Navy and Marine Corps aviators. While pilots 5 and 6 perform as solos, demonstrating the maximum performance capability of the aircraft. Once again, I'm Lieutenant Commander Cary Rickoff, Blue Angel number 7, and the narrator for the flight demonstration, as well as the pilot for key influencers and media personnel we normally fly at each show site. Blue Angel number 8, Lieutenant Commander Adam Kerrick from Stuyersville, Pennsylvania, is the squadron's naval flight officer and events coordinator. They're on the runway now, establishing their fingertip formation. They'll accelerate their engines to 85% power, carefully check their engine instruments, and give Captain Doyle a thumbs up, indicating they're ready to go. With a signal from each of his wingmen, Captain Doyle will call for the selection of afterburner, and the Blue Angel Diamond will initiate today's aerial demonstration. Accelerating to 150 miles per hour, he will pull back on the stick, flying the formation into the air. Immediately on liftoff, Major Mullins will call for the landing gear and flaps to come up as he moves into the slot position, and they commence the Diamond Half Squirrel Cage on takeoff.
Okay, ready?
Now to the left. Captain Doyle calls smoke on. Off brakes now. Burners ready now. And the Blue Angel Diamond is rolling. As they pass before you, you will notice the smoke is not visible while the engines are in afterburner.
Thank you.
this maneuver. The Diamond will experience up to 4 times the force of gravity as they complete this looping maneuver. Five and six are rolling. Blue Angel 5 will complete the dirty roll on takeoff, while Blue Angel 6 executes a precise low transition and pitches up vertically at 6 times the force of gravity. Push forward on the stick as they perform the opposing knife edge pass. The Diamond Roll. All four aircraft flying as one in this graceful 360-degree rolling maneuver. Approaching inverted from the left to the right, they will roll their aircraft 360 degrees over center point. The opposing inverted to inverted rolls. You know I said it, I'm better now, I only say that cause you're not around. To the left, the Diamond is setting up for their next maneuver. Approaching center point on Captain Doyle's command, all four pilots will simultaneously roll their aircraft 360 degrees as they perform the Diamond aileron roll. Here's Captain Doyle. Craft pilots and enthusiasts who appreciate the difficulties associated with carrier aviation will enjoy this next maneuver demonstrated by the two solo pilots. To the right, Lieutenant Commander Hempler and Lieutenant Commander Webb will establish a mirror image formation, but look closely for both aircraft in the carrier landing configuration as they approach for a maneuver we call the Fortis. Who must land their aircraft on a small and sometimes pitching deck of an aircraft carrier at sea. Slow-speed flight is just as important as high-speed flight. In order to demonstrate the dirty, slow-speed handling characteristics of the F-18, Captain Doyle has called for the extension of the landing gear and tail hooks by the four Diamond pilots as they execute a maneuver performed by no other jet demonstration team in the world today. From the left, the Diamond Dirty Loop. Of the F-18. He'll execute a 7.5G afterburning turn and exit the flight line vertically, showcasing the Hornet's slow speed climb capability. Aircraft 270 degrees and crossed with minimum separation. Observe as both pilots sustained six times the force of gravity across the aircraft over center.
Thank you.
178 miles per hour. The Blue Angel Echelon Parade. Two consecutive rolls totaling 720 degrees with a closure rate of over 800 miles per hour. The opposing horizontal rolls. Approaching center point, Captain Doyle will roll the formation 360 degrees into the three wingmen. During this extremely difficult maneuver, Major Mullins on the outpost position will experience four times the displacement generated by Captain Doyle's aircraft. Ladies and gentlemen, the Blue Angel left echelon roll. Leading their roll to the right, observe as the three wingmen smoothly shift back into the Blue Angel Diamond. You've seen firsthand the ability of a tactical aircraft at high speed to sneak into a target area virtually undetected. Lieutenant Commander Webb will complete the maneuver with a series of vertical rolls, while Lieutenant Commander Hempler completes his run with the diamond to the ground.
Hempler 5.4, cross the center point. Okay, roll. Okay, wing.
To the right, Lieutenant Commander Hempler has joined the diamond in a line abreast formation. Still maintaining minimum separation, the pilots must now align themselves by looking 90 degrees from their flight path towards Captain Doyle's aircraft. They'll climb up through vertical under heavy G as they perform the very difficult 5-plane line abreast loop. For another formation change prior to detaching Blue Angel number 5. You have seen several flight profiles of the F-18 Hornet. The two solo pilots will next demonstrate precision roll rate control. Approaching center point, they will roll their aircraft 360 degrees, pausing after each 90 degrees of rotation, crossing center point in the inverted position. The opposing 4-point hesitation rolls. Still a little bit rolling, still a little bit flashing, little fast. shift back into the view angel.
All right, hello, match wings. Go.
Split S, finishing with a dynamic separation maneuver. Formation pulls to level. Each pilot will perform an individual brake turn and exit the flight line in a separate direction. The Blue Angel, barrel roll brake. Ladies and gentlemen, the double tuck over rolls. For another dynamic maneuver, the low brake cross. Approaching center point, each pilot will form.
Command to air mismatch, have that line. Match roll out, three right, clear with a left.
As each aircraft accelerates to 500 miles per hour, they will perform a reversal turn back towards the flight line. You should be able to follow the individual smoke trails as all four aircraft converge on center point with maximum closure and minimum separation. less than 120 miles per hour, the fly-by-wire flight controls provide slow-speed handling that sets the Hornet apart in the air-to-air combat arena. This section high alpha pass. From the right, that's 400 miles per hour, the Delta roll. All five wingmen maintaining position as they roll the aircraft 360 degrees over center point. They exit to the left. Observe as Captain Doyle brings the formation back towards the flight line. Very shortly, all six aircraft will be approaching for the Blue Angel fleur-de-lis. In an aerial salute to our forward deployed forces, all six aircraft will separate, perform individual 360-degree rolls, and the four diamond pilots will rendezvous through a looping maneuver. From the left at 450 miles per hour, the Blue Angel fleur-de-lis. Let's listen in. closely as Captain Doyle calls. Smoke bomb, ready break. Accelerates to 500 miles per hour. They will perform a one-half Cuban A reversion turn. As they pull up and over the top, you should be able to follow the six smoke trails as all six pilots simultaneously roll the aircraft 180 degrees and head back towards show center point. From six different directions with maximum closure and minimum separation, they'll converge on center point and cross with a combined closure rate of nearly 1,000 miles per hour. In front of the crowd, the Delta is making its approach to the flight line. Approaching center point, the entire formation will separate in dramatic fashion. Ladies and gentlemen, the Blue Angel Delta breakout. Flight Demonstration Squadron represents a time-honored tradition of pride, professionalism, and excellence spanning 108 years of naval aviation. The 2019 team takes a great deal of pride in saluting Navy and Marine Corps pilots, maintenance crews, and support personnel everywhere. From the left, your 2019 Blue Angels. That they be able to land their aircraft on a ship at sea. Whether it's a tactical jet, a propeller-driven aircraft, or a helicopter, each requires a skill the naval aviator must master. In order to perfect this skill, Navy and Marine Corps pilots spend a great deal of time in the landing pattern practicing carrier approaches. In front of you now, Captain Doyle and his wingman will demonstrate a simulated carrier pattern. Approaching the runway from the left, Captain Doyle is confirming that the landing checks have been completed and that each aircraft is in fact ready to land. Rolling out on fire, they'll make constant power and lineup corrections, maintaining the optimal rate of descent for the proper touchdown.
Hey.
Okay.
The demonstration pilots you have been watching perform here this afternoon are but a small part of the Blue Angels team. The men and women in blue uniforms standing before you are members of the elite Blue Angel maintenance crew. Through hard work, long hours, and selfless dedication, they have each year for the past 73 years provided us with the aircraft availability necessary to perform each of these public demonstrations. As the aircraft taxi back, I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce the Blue Angel maintenance crew. Command Master Chief Chris Ziegler from West Monroe, Louisiana. Maintenance Master Chief Matthew Heathcote, Bradford, Illinois. Maintenance Chiefs Chris Massacott, Fort Walton Beach, Florida. Clint Smothers, Benton, Kentucky. Elizabeth Perez, El Paso, Texas. Crew Coordinator Jeff DeJuice, Gonai, Haiti. Crew Chief 1, Bobby Fitzpatrick, St. Louis, Missouri. First Mech Sean LeKirsten, Felon, California. Crew Chief 2, Jeremy Ray, Severn, Maryland. First Mech Darby Versluis, Neosho, Missouri. Crew Chief 3, Jermaine Corpus, Lahaina, Hawaii. First Mech Jack Reynolds, Lake Charles, Louisiana. Crew Chief 4, Ryan Johnson, Pensacola, Florida. First Mech Justin Johnson, Angola, Indiana. Crew Chief 5, Aldrich Kittles, Waynesboro, Georgia. First Mech Janet Madrigal, San Francisco, California. Crew Chief 6, Sam Peruca, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. First Mech Joanna Garcia, Mexico City, New Mexico. Crew Chief 7, Robert Weiderhausen, Sterling, Virginia. Runway Truck Alert Crew, Clint Blakemore, Sand Springs, Oklahoma. Ryan Bailey, Spokane, Washington. Scott Tomes, Louisville, Kentucky. Kyle Thompson from Warren, Michigan. And Tim Jose, East Berlin, Connecticut. Quality Assurance Representative, Ulysses Maldonado, San Juan, Puerto Rico. Aerospace Medicine Technician, Clarence Presley from Pompano Beach, Florida. Public Affairs Representative, Tim Schumacher from New Carlisle, Indiana. Video Technician, Andy Bennett, Holmesdale, Pennsylvania. And Julia DiMascola from California City, California. Logistics Support Representative Kwame Kusi from Kumasi, Ghana, and Deshante Williams from Jonesboro, Georgia. Maintenance Control Representative Savannah McPherson, Raleigh, North Carolina. Life Support Representative Cassandra Shiflin, Shawnee, Kansas. Support Crew, Jairo Gidi, La Cava, Honduras. Kyle Wood, Orange City, Florida. Chase Colt, Battleground, Washington. Trevor Wright, Baltimore. Yeah! Nathan Lyons, Stevenson, Farmington, New Mexico. Joshua Granger, Chatsworth, Georgia. Jaime Del Toro from Fresno, California. Anna Dela Cruz, Medilla, Philippines. Felix Ryer from Anaculia, Hawaii. Freddie Nunez, Moreno Valley, California. Daniel Munoz from Guayaquil, Ecuador. Jordan Walls, Lufkin, Texas. Tommy Tran, Round Rock, Texas. Jessica Dre, Portland, Maine. Jeremy Hall, Thorndale, Texas. Austin Michener from Chesterfield, Virginia. Darius Austin from Panama City, Florida. Our music choreographer, Denaja Carabella from York, Pennsylvania. And our C-130 crew, Steven Stewart from Jacksonville, Florida. Jason Glatfelter, Holtwood, Pennsylvania. Chris Maxheimer, Mount Pulaski, Illinois. Anthony Black from Newport Richey, Florida. And Chris Carter from Miami, Florida. Taxiing just in front of you, the Blue Angels will momentarily be turning into the parking area. After a short maintenance debrief, they'll be coming to the crowd line where you have an opportunity to meet the team. As they step away from their aircraft, I'd like to take one final opportunity to introduce the pilots you've been watching perform here this afternoon.
Back.
secure their engines, the pilots will simultaneously exit their aircraft on a signal from Captain Doyle. Once again, it's been our honor and our pleasure to perform for you here at Mather, this our 53rd flight demonstration of the 2019 season. The opposing solo from Lawton, Oklahoma, Lieutenant Commander Andre Webb. Flying Blue Angel number 5, the lead solo from Wamego, Kansas, Lieutenant Commander Brandon Hempler. Blue Angel number 4, the slot pilot from Memphis, Tennessee, Major Jeffrey Michael Mullins. Woo! Flying Blue Angel number 3, the left wingman from Chesapeake, Virginia, Lieutenant Jim Cox. Blue Angel number 2, the right wingman from Canadian, Texas, Lieutenant Commander James Haley. And flying Blue Angel number 1, the commanding officer and flight leader of the Blue Angels from League City, Texas, Captain Eric Doyle. Ladies and gentlemen, representing your United States Navy and Marine Corps, the Blue Angels 2019.
Wow, how about that, ladies and gentlemen? Once again, let's hear it for the Blue Angels. Now, of course, we invite you to wait some of the traffic out. Enjoy some of the exhibits that remain. Take your time and have a safe journey home. It's been quite a year.